So now let's practice a little bit the visibility and scope of different identifiers. In this little code, label for each usage of a variable or symbol in general, like a function, the definition that will be used. And finally, the question is, what does this function print? So here we have our first definition of identifier x, then y, then we get here our function, and here we see that here is x used and here is another y, and so forth, another block. So what is used on these different levels? So which value is definition is used for x and which one for y here? Is it definition 3? Is it definition 2? Is it definition 1? And so on. Think about it a couple of minutes and then I will show you the answer. So please pause the video now and think about it. Good idea is also to go back to those scope rules, and in particular we had been thinking about the scope rules here, the block scope for objects, and we learned just about global variables, which is also related. So here is now the solution. So basically in this definition 3, y shadows the definition of d2. So when we access it here and set y, we set the formal argument, so this object here, which represents y, we set this one, we don't change y over here. Okay, but x, well, there is no x known as part of this block or as part of this function scope, so we use the global variable x, so definition 1. Right, and then here we open a block, we declare a new x, so now this is a new definition, basically shadowing our definition 1. And when we print x now, well, we print this x, and this x is set here to y, where we set y here is to increment basically x and add 2. So x was initially 3, we increment 1 makes it 4, we add 2 makes y to be 6 here, and then we assign x to be 6, and so it prints 6. When we go to this point in the code, we shadow actually our x again, and so this x, this object x here, represents basically this definition here and not the definition 1.